हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक एनिसोट्रोपिक इफेक्ट एंड हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग. मीन्स इन द एनएमआर स्पेक्ट्रा व्हाट इफेक्ट आर ऑफ आर बाय द एनिसोट्रोपिक इफेक्ट एंड बाय द हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग ऑन द केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रोटॉन्स. दैट वॉज द रिजल्ट ऑफ एक्चुअल दैट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ एक्चुअली द शेल्डिंग एंड डिसशेल्डिंग ऑफ द प्रोटोन. मीन्स higher the electron density or lower the electron density around the protons. So hydrogen bonding affect this thing. Hydrogen bonding can increase or can decrease the electron density around the protons. While the anisotropic effect, you know, this also can be sealed or sealed the protons from the external magnetic field or the, you know, applied magnetic field to get the which is required to get the signal of the proton. So basically, some you know, some value of the applied magnetic field is required to get the NMR signals. And anisotropic effect if create a induced magnetic field, which may sealed or may desealed the, you know, the protons. Or we can say that may increase the applied magnetic field and reach to the apply to the protons. Or we can, or in the other way, it can oppose the applied magnetic field. And you know, in that case, hydrogen will feel, or the proton will feel lesser field that is required, lesser field than the required field to get the NMR signal. Okay. So we will discuss one by one these effects on the chemical shift value or the signal of the protons. So the learning objective of this lecture is to learn the concept of anisotropic effect and to know the type of shielding and deshielding of protons by anisotropic effect, that how or which type of the protons are deshielded and which type of the protons are shielded by the anisotropic effect. And after getting these points, we can, you know, analyze the NMR spectra to understand the structure of organic compounds. Because anisotropic effect and hydrogen bonding, you know, the observed in not only not in all the cases actually, not around the all protons. This is we observed in aromatic compounds or unsaturated compounds where only the double bond is present. Not in the case of triple bond. So unsaturated compound where alkene or aromatic where alkenes are present, or may not be there are also be other examples of the unsaturated compound like aldehyde, ketones, etc., carboxylic acids. In these cases, unsaturated compounds, anisotropic effects, you know, it creates or the induce such magnetic field where which, you know, the deshield the protons. And if deshielding of the proton is there, then the signal will appear at downfield region. As we have discussed in the previous classes, previous lecture, that the decreased electron density around the proton deshield the protons. And if these protons are deshielded, then their signal will appear in the, at the downfield region. It means at the, you know, down magnetic field. Okay, means less magnetic field is required to get the NMR signal of that less electron density containing protons. But if the electron density around the proton is higher, then we have to put higher applied magnetic field to get the, or to you know, to make the protons in the resonance and to get the NMR spectra. Right? So these are very much, you know, very important factors which are either desealed or sealed the protons. For example, if you talk about the hydrogen bonding, in case of amines and in case of the alcohols, hydrogen bonding occurs. And this hydrogen bonding can also increase, or you know, this can also decrease the electron density around the protons and can deseal the protons, which is just the shifting of the proton NMR signal into the downfield region. Now the learning outcome of this lecture, student would be able to get the concept of an isotropic effect and hydrogen bonding, and would be able to determine the types of protons in sample compound. And once we can, you know, detect the types of the protons, type of the groups in the compound. For example, suppose we are taking the NMR signal of the aromatic compound, okay? Or we can say that in we are taking the NMR spectra of the unknown compound, but our spectra are, you know, our signals are observed. We are observing the signal in the spectrum in between 7 to 9 value, 7 to 9 delta value. It means actually the NMR signals between 7 to 9 delta value will observe for aromatic compounds, for aromatic protons. So by getting the signals of the unknown sample, if it is observing in the appearing in the you know, range 7 to 9, then we can easily identify that the protons are aromatic, right? Means these are the protons which are the part of the aromatic, you know, aromatic units. So let's come on the topic, an isotropic effect. So this effect constitutes shielding and deshielding effect on the protons because of induced magnetic field in other part of the molecule which operate through space. So an isotropic effect, this can constitute actually, this may shield or this may deshield the protons. This depends upon the, you know, the direction or the space from which this is operating. This is operating or this the anisotropic effect either, you know, the generating induced magnetic field in the right angle of the applied magnetic field or opposite to the applied magnetic field. Okay. For example, if a magnetic field is applied to a molecule having pi electrons, these electrons begin to circulate at right angle to the direction of the applied field, thereby producing the induced magnetic field. Okay, so if induced magnetic field is in the direction of applied magnetic field, then this will deshield the proton. And the effect of this field on the nearby protons has been found to depend upon the orientation of the proton with respect to the pi bond, producing the induced field. So now, shielding and deshielding of the proton will depend upon the orientation of the protons. Either the proton is present in the in such a space where the induced magnetic field of the anisotropic effect is in right angle of the applied magnetic field. Then in that case, proton will be deshielded. But if the protons are present in such a space, means orientation of the protons are in such a way, that the induced magnetic field is in opposite to that of the applied magnetic field direction, then in that case, this induced magnetic field by circulation of pi electron density will shield the proton, will oppose the applied magnetic field, which was required for the generating of signal for the protons. So in that case, if the proton is present in such a in such place in the space where the induced magnetic field is in opposite direction to that of the external magnetic field, then it will oppose. And if induced magnetic field opposes the external magnetic field, then proton will feel lesser field which was required for generating the signal. It means signal will not generate in that case. So to get the signal, we have to off the external magnetic field. Means suppose 50 Gauss magnetic field was required to get the signal of the proton, and we have applied the 50 external magnetic field, 50 Gauss. But the induced field, magnetic field, which was opposite in the direction, or which is opposing the applied magnetic field, the value is suppose induced magnetic field value is suppose 5 Gauss. So by the 5 Gauss, induced magnetic field will oppose the external magnetic field. So the protons will feel only 45 Gauss magnetic field. And now we have to increase 55 Gauss, remaining 5 Gauss magnetic field more. So it means the total applied magnetic field we have to put to get the NMR signal of the proton would be 55. But for a negged proton, the required was 50. So from the negged proton, the field required in the, you know, the in the alkene or the aromatic compounds sorry in the case of alkyne, in case of alkyne, the proton is present in the opposite direction of the applied magnetic field. Okay, so in case of alkyne, they sealed the proton, induced magnetic field sealed the proton. If they sealed, then their signal will appear in the higher region, higher magnetic field. Okay, this can be explained on the basis of, or by taking the example, following the example. This is the example here. This is the example of benzene. Here the black line is the, you know, the skeleton, carbon skeleton of the benzene. Okay, these are here the each corner, this corner representing the carbon atom 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six corners are here, means six carbon are here, and sigma bonds are there, means carbons are connected by the sigma bonds. And here also these lobes of the p orbital, which are perpendicular to this plane of this ring. And these orbitals which are present at each carbon, they are also forming bond, which are called pi bonds, okay, by the collateral overlapping. So these pi bonds actually are at the alternate position. And continuously circulating in this ring, means delocalizing in this ring. So whenever we applied the magnetic field, we put the compound in the magnetic field, then there is actually the circulation of these, the spinning motion of the electrons. And due to this motion, circulation of these pi electrons, there are generation of two types of the field, induced magnetic fields. One field have the direction, this is one field have the direction at the right angle of the applied magnetic field, because this is the B naught is the applied magnetic field. B naught is the applied magnetic field. This is in this direction. And the induced magnetic field at this position also in this direction, upward direction. Applied magnetic field is also in the upward direction, and induced magnetic field is also in the upward direction. So in this case, this induced magnetic field, which is represented by the gray lines, they add up into the applied magnetic field. Suppose applied magnetic field is 50 Gauss and the induced magnetic field is 5 Gauss, then this will add up in the applied magnetic field. So in that case, दिस प्रोटॉन विल फेल 55 गोस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, 50 + 5 इज 55, बट रिक्वायर्ड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वॉज ओनली 50. सो बिफोर कमिंग एंड बिफोर कम ऑन टू द वैल्यू 50 गोस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, वेन एवर दिस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वॉज रीच्ड एट 45, 45 ओनली 45 मीन्स वी हैव अप्लाइड द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड इट्स वैल्यू इज इंक्रीजिंग. सो वेन एवर इट्स वैल्यू वॉज 45, देन 45 + 5 विच इज इंड्यूस्ड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, दे एड अप एंड दे कंक्लूडेड द रिजल्टेंट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड 50 गोस. सो इन दैट केस द प्रोटॉन फील्ड 50 गोस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विच वॉज रिक्वायर्ड. सो आवर स्पेक्ट्रा वॉज ऑब्जर्व एट ओनली द 45 एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, 45 गोस एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. ओके मीन्स 5 गोस लेसर देन दी रिक्वायर्ड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड आवर स्पेक्ट्रा विल ऑब्जर्व. इट मीन्स अवर स्पेक्ट्रा ऑब्जर्व इन दी लोअर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वैल्यू. सो इफ स्पेक्ट्रा ऑब्जर्व इन दी लोअर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वैल्यू देन वॉट वी कॉल इट, वी विल कॉल इट दैट दी शिफ्टिंग ऑफ दिस सिग्नल इज ऑब्जर्व एट दी और दी सिग्नल इज शिफ्टेड इन दी डाउन फील्ड रीजन, मीन्स सिग्नल इज अपियर एट दी लेसर फील्ड और डाउन फील्ड, मीन्स सिग्नल इज शिफ्टेड इन टू डाउन फील्ड, दैट इज कॉल्ड डाउन फील्ड शिफ्टिंग. ओके और वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट दिस इंड्यूस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड डिसील दिस प्रोटोन, मीन्स इंड्यूस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज यू नो रेनफोर्सिंग द अप्लाइड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड हेल्पिंग हेल्पिंग द अप्लाइड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड टू रीच एट द प्रोटोन्स, मीन्स दिस इज डिसील्डिंग द प्रोटोन. बट इफ दिस प्रोटोन इज प्रेजेंटेड हियर बट इन द केस ऑफ बेंजीन और इन द एरोमेटिक कंपाउंड्स इन द एल्डिहाइड कीटोन्स एक्सेट्रा इन द एल्डिहाइड एरोमेटिक कंपाउंड एंड एलिफेटिक एल्कीन्स द प्रोटोन इज प्रेजेंट इन दी दिस डिसील्डिंग जोन, दिस डिसील्डिंग जोन एंड इन दैट केस देयर सिग्नल्स ऑब्जर्व इन दी वेरी मच यू नो डाउन फील्ड रीजन. ओके दैट्स द रीजन वाई द एरोमेटिक कंपाउंड कंपाउंड प्रोटोन सिग्नल्स अपेयर्ड एट वेरी लो डाउन फील्ड अराउंड 6 to 9 डेल्टा पीपीएम वैल्यू. हियर दीज आर सर्कुलेटिंग पाई इलेक्ट्रॉन्स क्रिएटिंग डिसील्डिंग जोन, हियर हाइड्रोजन इज प्रेजेंट इन डिसील्डिंग जोन एंड फील्ड एड टूगेदर हियर इंड्यूस्ड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड अप्लाइड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड द एड टूगेदर द सेकेंडरी मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जनरेटिंग बाई सर्कुलेटिंग पाई इलेक्ट्रॉन्स डिसील्डिंग एरोमेटिक प्रोटोन्स. ओके एंड द सेम केस इज इन दी एलिफेटिक एल्किन, इन द एलिफेटिक एल्किन दीज प्रोटोन्स आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन दी डिसील्डिंग जोन, दीज आर द डिसील्डिंग जोन हियर, हियर दीज आर प्रोटोन्स आर प्रेजेंट एंड हियर द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द इंड्यूस्ड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज इन द राइट एंगल ऑफ द अप्लाइड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. ओके so these are also these protons are also disillusioned by this induced magnetic field generated by the circulation of pi electrons, it is called secondary magnetic field or we can say anisotropic effect. Okay so these lines are actually the field lines. Which field? Disillusioned field. But opposite to that disildiing zone in case of alkyne, this is the alkyne compound here, carbon triple bond carbon means triple bond is there between carbon and carbon, or we can say carbon carbon are connected by the triple bond character, and in this triple bond two bonds which are two bonds are actually the pi bonds and one bond is sigma bond. These pi electrons are circulating and creating here also creating the induced magnetic field. But the direction of induced magnetic field here in the center, in the center line, this gear, this induced magnetic field is rotating in this way. This is the direction. So in the outer part here, this is in this direction, upward direction. Okay. Or we can say right angle of the, or we can say in the direction of the applied magnetic field. Well, when this is coming in the center, where this is coming downward side here. And here in the, when it is coming in the downward side, where hydrogen is present. So here this hydrogen is present, and this hydrogen is here exist in the induced magnetic field, which is in the opposite direction to that of the applied magnetic field, because its direction is upward and its direction is here downward. This is downward. This is downward direction. Okay. So here, this is also downwards. This is the arrow, which is more coming to downward side. Okay. So means the induced magnetic field generates here. The generated induced magnetic field here, shielding the protons, this hydrogen. And this hydrogen will feel lesser field than that of V applied to get the signal of this proton. Means, in that case, this proton will not, give the signal in the spectrum. So to get the signal of these protons, which is present in the shielding zone, we have to apply magnetic field. We have to increase the magnetic field more. And when we increase the applied magnetic field more, then the, the required for the negative proton, then at the increasing magnetic field, the signal of this proton will observed. Means the signal of this proton will observe at the high field region. High field region. Okay. Then compared to the Elkin protons. Now, the proton attached to sp2 hybridized carbon are less shielded than those attached to sp3 hybridized carbon. So actually, in case of alkenes, this is alkene, this is alkene, this is actually aromatic alkene, aliphatic alkene, and this is aromatic alkene. So in the case of alkenes, there are sp2 hybridized carbon. sp2 hybridized, all the carbons are actually the sp2 hybridized. And sp2 hybridized carbon have the more electronegativity, and it decreases the electron density on the proton. Okay. Means it's so the minus effect on this proton. And second thing is that by the circulation of these pi electrons, there is also an isotropic effect, and which also deceals the protons. There are two effects, minus I and anisotropic effect, which is deshielding the proton or decreasing the electron density around the protons. We deshield the protons, and deshielding the proton shifted the signal of NMR in the NMR spectrum towards downfield region. So we can identify the compound that by getting the signal at the particular value of the in the NMR spectrum, we can identify the unknown compound that which type of the protons are present. Either the protons are sp3 hybridized attached with the sp3 hybridized carbon, or the protons are attached with the sp2 hybridized carbon, और दीज आर दी कंपाउंड इन विच कार्बन इज एसपी हाइब्रिडाइज्ड, बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ एसपी हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन, एसपी टू हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन एंड एसपी थ्री हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन, दी प्रोटॉन्स फील डिफरेंट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बिकॉज दी आर शील्डिंग एंड डिसील्डिंग इज ऑफ डिफरेंट एक्सटेंट, राइट? फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू कैन सी हियर इजली द डेल्टा वैल्यू, आई मीन दी केमिकल शिफ्ट वैल्यू फॉर एरोमेटिक प्रोटॉन इज एन इज अराउंड 7.3 ppm. फॉर बेंजीन एक्चुअली इट इज ऑब्जर्व एट 7.3 ppm. बट इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द डेल्टा एनवार सिग्नल, देन दे अपीयर फॉर दिस एल्किन, एलिफेटिक एल्किन एट 5.3 ppm वैल्यू. वेल इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द एलिफेटिक एंड CH3 CH3 प्रोटॉन्स ऑफ प्रेजेंट इन द एल्केन, देन द डेल्टा वैल्यू इज अराउंड 0.9 ppm. मीन्स डेल्टा वैल्यू इज लेसर हियर, मीन्स सिग्नल इज ऑब्जर्विंग इन द वेरी हाई फील्ड रीजन और एट वेरी हाई मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. डोंट कन्फ्यूज फ्रॉम द वैल्यू, डेल्टा वैल्यू एक्चुअली, बिकॉज दी स्केल और इन दी एनिमल स्पेक्ट्रम द स्केल ऑफ डेल्टा वैल्यू एंड द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड आर इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. ओके, मीन्स वेन वी इंक्रीज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड मीन्स प्रोटोन्स आर गेटिंग इन द रेजोनेंस एट हाई फील्ड, मीन्स द डेल्टा वैल्यू विल बी लोअर. ओके, एंड इट मीन्स द सिग्नल इज शिफ्टिंग इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. ओके, एट द फील्ड डायरेक्शन. ओके, एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड अ फील्ड शिफ्टिंग. नाउ the acidic proton, this is actually carboxylic acid, and this carboxylic acid gives H plus ion. Actually, this shows resonance, and due to this resonance, there is generation of actually positive charge here, because this oxygen here is trivalent, and in the case of trivalent, oxygen is get positively charged. Okay, so both resonance and the electronegative effect of the oxygen withdraw electrons from the acidic proton. Due to the minus effect of this oxygen and CO group, this hydrogen get electron deficient, first thing. And second thing, due to the resonance phenomenon, is lone pair of electron of this oxygen, this participate in the resonance in the conjugation with this double bond. Actually, lone pair of electron participate in the formation of double bond here, and the double bond electron density shift towards oxygen. That's why this oxygen get negatively charged, and here double bonds are present, and positive charge is present here on this oxygen, and positively charged center is, you know, the more electronegative than the neutral center. So this high electronegative center will attract the said electron density from the OH bond, and OH get electron deficient. So due to minus effect and due to resonance effect, this proton is get electron deficient. And this is released in the form of proton. In the form of proton, because if it does not release from this position, then the positively charged oxygen, this oxygen, positively charged oxygen containing this structure is actually the less stable. But whenever, as soon as this the release the H plus ion from here, its positive charge nullified. And this gas stabilizes, and its new resonating structure will also form, which is just same to that of this structure. Okay, so after the removal of H plus ion, this compound get stabilized. Its resonating structures get stabilized, more stabilized. That's the reason why this compound so acidic property, because the compound which releases H plus ion is act as acid. And here this also releases plus ion, so this also acts as acid. Sn. And the strength of the acid depend upon the stability of the negatively charged resonating structures. Negatively charged structures after removal of the express ion. So as increase the stability of the or you know the edge, as increase the stability of the negatively charged this structure after the removal of H plus ion, there increase the acidic strength of the acid. Okay, because in the universe, each and every system wants to move for their more stability, towards more stability. For example, water from mountain fall down by the waterfalls to the rivers, and rivers move towards oceans where this water get stabilized. And we are also human beings also wants to get stabilized for stability. They make, they prepare house and people are getting house. They move here and there to earn some money, earn money and prepare house, and then they stabilize. Otherwise, those persons which are not actually, having house, homes, which are, they spend their time in the footpath, on the footpaths, they are not stable. They move here and there all time. Okay. And they also wants to get stability. And for their stability, government is working here. Government is working. Government providing house to those persons for their stability. Okay, so this compound also for getting the stability is released as ion. Okay, and act as acid. Now the hydrogen bonding and deshielding the protons. Hydrogen bonding actually deshield the proton. Here this is the ROH alcohol molecule. This is also ROH, but here if you can see here this, you can easily see here this is hydrogen. And this is present between the oxygen and oxygen. High electronegative atoms. So when hydrogen is present, this exists between two high electronegative atoms, then there is formation of hydrogen bonding. And by this hydrogen bonding, these two molecule, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I mean this alcohol and this alcohol molecule, they are attached to each other. So when they form hydrogen bonding, suppose this molecule and this molecule, they are forming hydrogen bonding. This molecule to molecule to ROH molecule forming hydrogen bonding. So this hydrogen bonded, this hydrogen, which is bonded with two oxygens here and here, is deshielded by this hydrogen bond, because in this separate ROH molecule only one oxygen which is attracting the electrons from this bond, but here also second oxygen which is also attracting the electron density from the nucleus, this nucleus or the hydrogen or the protons. So both the oxygen atom that are powerful high electronegative, which have high electronegativity, attract the electron density from this hydrogen and deshield this proton, decreases the electron density around this proton, means deshielded this proton. And in that case, when we apply the less magnetic field, then it feels the magnetic field and its signal will appear in the spectra. So the chemical shift depends on how much hydrogen bonding is taking place in concentrated solution. And this hydrogen bonding lengthen the OH bond and reduces the valence electron density around the protons. So it is distributed and shifted downfield in the NMR spectrum. Some more extreme examples are here, RCOH, COR. Here RCO, OH, and here HOCOR means there are two carboxylic acids, RCOOH. This is carboxylic acid, and HOCOR. This is also carboxylic acid. So both the carboxylic acid form hydrogen bond here. This hydrogen is forming hydrogen bond between with this oxygen, and here this hydrogen is also forming hydrogen bond with this oxygen. Okay, so there are two hydrogen bonds, means these two carboxylic acid molecules are attached with each other by two hydrogen bonds. Okay, so this is called actually the dimer. Actually two monomer are attaching to each other, so this is called dimer of this carboxylic acid. So carboxylic acid have actually the strong hydrogen bonding, and they form dimer form they are. And by the forming of this hydrogen bond, their hydrogens get desilted. That's the reason why their delta value for hydrogen of these carboxylic acids are actually at very low magnetic field, means at very high delta value. And this is around actually the 10 to 12 delta value. Very desilted proton these are, because electron density around these protons are very less due to the minus I effect, strong minus I effect of these two high electronegative atom. Here is also the hydrogen bonding between the hydrogen of this OH group and this oxygen, and this is also desilting this proton in the methyl salicylate. This is the methyl salicylate molecule which has a strong internal hydrogen bonding. By this external internal hydrogen bonding, this molecule form a chelate, or we can say cycle, or we can ring. Okay, and here this ring is formed, actually the six membered ring it is. Now these are the delta values, chemical shift values for different type of the proton, where we can easily see the anisotropic effect here in this case, here, yeah, in this case, here. The delta value or chemical shift value for these protons are actually in between 6.5 to 9. Very high value means very low field strength is required to get the signal for these protons. Okay, high delta value means low field. Required field is low if the delta value is high, or if the delta value is low, then the required field is high. Okay, and for RCOS, this is delta value is also very high, 5 to 9. For carboxylic acid proton, 11 to 12, it is very high. For aldehyde, is also very high. In the aldehyde, also hydrogen present at the sp2 hybridized carbon. In case of aldehyde, this hydrogen is present at the sp2 hybridized carbon. And in case of sp2 hybridized carbon, there is an anisotropic effect. So due to the anisotropic effect, there is induced magnetic field, which is reinforcing the applied magnetic field or desilt this proton very high. And if desilt this proton very high, then its signal will be shifted in the very low field region. Okay, now the MCQs, the first question is, anisotropic effect is due to presence of sigma bond, pi bond, both sigma and pi bond, and none of these. So in which compound anisotropic effect is operating? This is operating in the pi bonds, in case of pi bonds, where hydrogen is present with the pi bond dead center. Second question is, anisotropic effect constitutes shielding and desilting effect on the proton because of So this is because of induced magnetic field, proton density, electron density, induced magnetic field, external magnetic field. So what? This is actually the because of induced magnetic field. The question number third, the effect of this field on the nearby proton has been found to depend upon the dot 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 with respect to the pi volts producing the induced magnetic field. So a proton is shielded or deshielded will depends upon the orientation of the proton. Orientation of the proton in the induced magnetic field. If the proton is present in the deshielding zone, then proton will be deshielded. Or if these are oriented in the space or in the such region where protons are present in the shielding zone, then in this proton will be shielded. Okay. Now the secondary magnetic field generated by circulating electrons or robotic protons. Secondary magnetic field generating by circulating electrons, dot dot aromatic protons. So what effect will be there for the aromatic protons? This will deseal the aromatic protons. And the question number five, what is correct order of chemical shift of protons attached to sp3, sp2 and sp hybridized carbon? So actually the question is actually the for what protons, which protons the chemical shift value is highest. The chemical shift value is highest for sp for actually the sp2 hybridized carbon. And the chemical shift depends on how much dot dot is taking place. How much hydrogen bonding? As increase the hydrogen bonding, it will shift this signal into the downfield region. Next question is hydrogen bonding lengthen the OH bond and reduce the electron density around the proton, which deshielded the proton and shifted the signal into the downfield region. Okay. So the correct option will be B, electron density. And now next question is, what is range of delta value for protons of aldehyde group? So for aldehyde proton, what will the value of, what is the value of actually the delta value? So this is around 9 to 10. And for benzene and its derivative protons, the delta value is 6 to 9. And if you talk about the range of delta value for proton of alkanes. So alkanes protons are actually the very high shielded. They are very highly shielded protons. And to get the signal of these protons, we have to apply more and more field. Means we have to up the field. Means their signal observed at the high field region. Means delta value less. So lesser delta value is actually 0 to 2. So if there is not the presence of heteroatom like oxygen, nitrogen, halides, etc., then the signal of alkanes observed within the range 0 to 2. Okay. But if there is the presence of heteroatom like oxygen, which is directly connected with the carbon, and proton is also present with the carbon, then this proton, which is connected with the same carbon to that of the connected with the oxygen, the proton get deshielded and this observed in a low field region, means high value. Okay. Now these are reference books by R. Sharma and Robert Silverstein. These are their PDF link. You just copy it and paste on the Google and you will get the PDF of these books. Thank you. So I am thankful to you all. Sincerely, with discipline. And if still you have any type of doubt, any question, any query, you can ask to me, you can call to me. I would be happy to answer you. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.